Let us continue our worship service with our call to worship in unison. Light the lamps, prepare the room. God is coming to us. Make our hearts and spirits ready to receive God's most gracious gift, God's Son, Jesus Christ. Push the darkness away. The light is truly coming. May God's light shine on us, in us, and through us, that God's glory may be seen. Amen.
Once God's plan was a mystery hidden from our sight. Now God has disclosed what was kept secret for so very long. He has brought it out in the light, in the brighter light on this fourth Sunday in Advent. May we see more clearly in the glory of God in Christ and sing the steadfast love and the love forever.
With my mouth, I will proclaim your faithfulness to all generations. I declare that your steadfast love is established forever. Your faithfulness is as firm as the heavens.
Light four candles, see them glow brightly, so that all may know how four candles show the way, making our darkness as bright as God's day. I declare that your steadfast love is established forever. Your faithfulness is as firm as the heavens.
Dear God, your faith, please pray in unison. Dear God, your faithfulness has been great, leading us to this day in anticipation and celebration. May the glorious light of your steadfast love shine brightly in us and through us, that all may give you praise and glory. In the Savior name we pray. Amen.
Please join me in the opening prayer. In the rush of preparation for holiday celebration, we come to this place to be fed by God. We need the peace, hope, love, and joy that this season represents. We need to listen again with wonder at the magnificent words of Mary as she proclaims her faithful participation in God's most miraculous gift. Open our hearts this day, Lord, to receive the words and the blessings to be fed, and then to be those who will share with others as you have shared with us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. just as the angels said. You'll find him in a manger bed. Emmanuel and Savior, hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Old Testament scripture reading this morning is from Psalm chapter 89, verses 1 through 4. And we read, I will sing of the Lord's greatest love forever. With my mouth, I will make your faithfulness known through all generations. I will declare that your love stands firm forever, that you have established your faithfulness in heaven itself. You said, I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant, I will establish your line forever and make your throne firm through all generations. The word of God for the people of God. Please join me now in the prayer, unison prayer of personal reflection. It's getting harder and harder to focus on the true meaning of Christmas, the incarnation of God's love in the birth of God's Son, Jesus Christ. We are caught in the web of festivities, travel, gifts, and glitter. And we admit that we really do enjoy all the holiday opportunities. But as we get closer to the big family celebrations and the actual celebration of Christmas, we begin to wonder, how are we going to survive it all? Help us to make some changes in our lives so that this time of celebration may have the deepest sense of joy and purpose. Keep us focused on the eternal yes response to your call to us, to live our lives as those who would joyfully serve you. Heal and comfort us, Lord, this day and always. For we ask this in the name of Jesus, our Savior. Amen.
Our New Testament reading this morning comes from the Gospel of Luke. Reading chapter 1, verses 26 through 38. In the 6 months of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and the angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Mary, you have found favor with God, and you will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call his name Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." And the angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you." Well, actually, Mary said, "How will this be?" And Mary asked the angel, "Since I'm a virgin." And the angel answered her, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One will be born and will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be unable to conceive is in her 6th month already. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." And the angel left her. I love surprises. I love change. I love bringing reality sometimes to the story that we've heard over and over and over again. I would like you to participate in this story this morning. How would you like to be a part of the Christmas story in some way? Would you like that? I think you would. I think all of you, in your childlike self, could be an animal of sorts. Don't you think? Absolutely. Well, I'm inviting a whole barn full or a stable full of animals here this morning, and you are them. How about that? And I'm especially excited because the kids are here, and if anybody knows how to speak like an animal or sound like an animal, they do. Yes, they do. Well, I've invited the cows to be with us today. I've invited chickens to come into the barn, horses, pigs, ducks, and even cats. We forgot the dogs this time. We'll bring them next year. Now, let's practice a little bit. What do you think a cow sounds like? Oh, we've got some farmers here. Cool, is that? Yes, moo. And you kids can moo as loud as you want. What do you think chickens sound like? Absolutely. And horses? Nay. Okay. And pigs? Oink, 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 oink. Some of you are really good at this. How about ducks? Quack, 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 quack. Good, good, good. And cats? Meow. Okay. We're ready for our story in Bethlehem. It would be a quiet night in the stable in Bethlehem, except that the animals themselves could not sleep. It seemed that a bright and mysterious light was shining through the window of the barn, not to mention that there was a large crowd that had gathered in the city over the last few days. They were all there to pay taxes. It was an unwelcome noise of people to the barn. All the animals felt a strange vibe. What is this? Why is this happening to our quiet, small town of Bethlehem? Something was different than most nights that the animals knew. The cows and the chickens and the pigs and the cats and the ducks and the horses, they were all upset because off in the distance they saw a small donkey coming to their stable. The donkey was tired after a long journey, and she was looking for a place to lay in some hay. She was told by the innkeeper that she would have bedding for the night, because her owners, Mary and Joseph, had to stay there too. However, when her masters came, Joseph and Mary, and showed up at the stable, it seemed like the donkey had to do a little explaining to all the other animals why they were there. Beulah was the name of the donkey, and I will play her part. She came in, and she decided to tell the mystery or solve the mystery of the big star in the sky. She said to all the other animals, "Did you know that the star up in the sky is there because a king is coming to Bethlehem?" They all looked at her so strangely. "Yes," she said, "and it's not necessarily a royal king." Well, the other animals got all upset because they were already starting to shine their hooves and gather their wool for a special present for royalty. "No," she said, "Beulah says it's not a king, big king, royal king. It's going to be a little baby." A baby? When the animals discovered that it was a human baby, they were a little disappointed. But then when Beulah told them it would be someone of extraordinary significance to the world, they listened up. Now, when I mention the name of an animal, and then I tell you what the animal is going to say. When I say cows, what do you do? Moo. Right. Okay. Let's start with the cows. Moo. What star is so bright? What do you think that is for? And the chicken said, and the horses added? Well, let's just look outside, they said. And the duck said? Oh, my webbed feet, look at the size of that star. It's so big and gorgeous. And then the pigs came along. The light may be affecting our sleep, don't you think? It's like daylight in here in the stable, and we're not even going to get some shut-eye. And then the cow said, moo, it's gonna be a long night. And Beulah then answers them, hi, I just wanna introduce myself to you. The innkeeper said I could come to the stable and there might be a place I could lay in the hay. Can you make room for me? I'm a donkey. And the horses said, hey, you poor little thing. You look so exhausted. Come on in and sit down. We'll make some hay space for you just because you're a donkey. And Beulah says, thank you so much. It really feels great to be in a warm, cozy place. Then all of a sudden, the cows and the horses and the ducks and the chickens and the pigs, and you can pick whichever one. Got you all confused. Well, it's nice to meet you, Beulah. Thanks for sharing your barn with me, the donkey said. And then the cows made a statement. Where are you from? Beulah says, I'm from Nazareth. And then the pigs asked, Nazareth, that's a long ways from here. And Beulah says, I know. It's taken us several days to get here, and boy, are we tired. And then the horses spoke up. Nay, 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 nay. Who's us? We only see you. Beulah says, oh, my masters, the people that rode on me, Mary and Joseph, they are here, and Mary is going to have a baby. Whoa. And the duck said, quack, 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 quack. Why are you here so far from home if Mary is having a baby? Beulah says, well, Joseph and Mary had to come because everyone in the city is here to pay their taxes. And the chickens replied, haven't you seen the crowds and the people in the streets all here to pay their taxes? And then the cows spoke up, moo. Well, that's government for you. I like those cows. And then the cat said, meow, meow. They weren't the only ones, though. I saw people traveling in from all over the country to pay their taxes. And then the donkey replied, this is such an unusual night. My lady, my owner Mary, she's going to give birth to a son, and they're going to call his name Jesus. And you know what? He's going to be special. He is going to be the Messiah that the Jews and the people of this land have been looking for a long, long time. And then the chicken said, well, that's one mystery solved. We've heard about that for generations. What other surprises do you have for us, donkey? And the horses said, nay, nay. Well, that sounds like a miracle to me. And then the pig said, While the innkeeper did say at one time that the star in the sky would point to where the child was laying, and it was that child that would be the king and the savior to the whole world. And then Beulah the donkey replies, "You know, I remember Joseph repeating the story from Isaiah. And he said this, 'For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace.'" And you know, there's a scripture in Luke, and it's an amazing rendition of the birth of Christ. "And there were shepherds living out in the field nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. And the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that is here for all of your people. Today in the town of David, a Savior is going to be born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you, and you will find a babe wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests.'" I guess the message for us this morning is, in a time and a world where we feel sometimes afraid, and we all do, there is nothing to be afraid of. For men and women and children and cows and chickens and ducks and horses and pigs and cats, and we'll even include dogs, there is nothing to be afraid of because the Savior has come.
Hear the angels singing joyful news to all the earth. Tidings they are bringing of the Savior's birth.
Hear the angels singing joyful news to all the earth. Tidings they are bringing of the Savior's birth.
Son is born so dear.
most merciful God. We come at this holiest of days. We come to know your everlasting love for us. And you did this by sending Jesus Christ our way. We seek this morning for a deeper meaning in our own lives. And we have come seeking for that heartfelt meaning of Christ. Make your presence known to each one of us this day. And we pray for our loved ones who are in need of hope and encouragement because they are suffering with either illness, loneliness, distress. We pray for those who are grieving today because they now have a loved one gone from their lives. Comfort them in their sorrow. Soothe their pain of loss and remind them that in the resurrection of our Lord, we have everlasting life. And we also pray today for ourselves. We pray that you will touch our souls in a way that will help us to know you more deeply. We also pray for our world today. Perhaps the calmness and the stillness of this day may serve as an example for us and those around the world, that we can possibly have peace even for a moment. We pray for peace and goodwill to all that live and are trying to survive. Make our prayers represent what is in our minds and in our hearts. And may we be do-gooders and bring goodwill to all. And now we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed it be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
know, as Jesus gathered with his disciples on that final night, I can't even imagine what that must have been like for him. Knowing life would be different. It would change. But also knowing that because of his sacrifice, the world would be changed. It would be redeemed. It would be better. The gift of love. And as Jesus gathered at that table, he lifted up a loaf of bread and he broke it. And he said, "This is my body, which is broken for you. And every time you eat of this bread, family meal as we gather together, use it in remembrance of me." And then he took a goblet of wine and he poured it into a cup. And he said, "This is my blood, which is shed for your sins. This is a new covenant that I've established in the world until I come again. And every time you drink of this cup together, remember me." That's why we are here today, is to remember him. Let us pray for the elements. Almighty God, we give you thanks for the gift of our Savior's presence in the simplicity and the splendor of this holy meal. Unite us with all who are fed by Christ's body and blood, that we may faithfully proclaim the good news of your love, and that your universal church may be a rainbow of hope to a very uncertain world. We pray these things on the bread and the wine in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and our Redeemer. Amen.
Thank you.
Now go forth into the world to serve God with gladness. To be of good courage, hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor all people. Love and serve God. Go with the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.